نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه، أرسله المولى عز وجل بشيرا ونذيرا بين يدي الساعة، عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سار على نهجه أفضل الصلاة والسلام. عباد الله، اتقوا الله فإنها وصية ربكم إليكم. قال سبحانه وتعالى: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. وقال عز وجل: يا أيها الذين آمنوا، يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. My dear brothers in Islam, as you know, this week all the media, all channels, people everywhere, they are expecting what they call it Christmas. What does mean Christmas for us as a Muslim? This question that we should ask, unfortunately, because there are many Muslims, they are not aware of the importance of knowing this matter and what should be the stand of the Muslim in such occasions. Let's see what we read in every rak'ah in salah. We always, we read, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. We repeat this ayah every salah, in every rak'ah. What does it mean? Guide us to the straight path, the path of those upon whom you have bestowed favor, not of those who have evoked your anger or of those who are striving. Now, we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and we read this verse. Many Muslims, they don't know what does it mean. What's the real application of this dua? So have we ever, or any one of us ever thought, contemplate in the deep meaning of this dua that we repeat in every rak'ah, in every salah? My dear brothers, it is dua, it is a reminder at the same time. It is a reminder for us of the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He bestowed upon us, that He guided us to the truth, guided us to Islam, guided us to His way. At the same time, we ask Allah azza wa jal to keep us on this path. Ihdina, guide us. Are not we guided as a Muslim? We are, alhamdulillah, we were guided to this. But have we guaranteed that we'll keep on this path? This is why we repeat this ayah, which we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always, oh Allah, guide us. That's been keep us on this path. At the same time, my dear brothers, we are in fear. Fear of what? Fear that we may lose it, either following the people with no knowledge, wildly misguided, or those who have knowledge but in the wrong way, the wrong knowledge. This is the way that we ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to get us far away off. So therefore we ask Allah to keep us in this straight path that lead us to what? To His pleasure and to His channel. My dear brothers, it is must on every Muslim believe in Allah and believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that he should be proud of his religion. You were honored to be the follower of the best of all prophets, the seal of prophethood, the leader of all messengers. You were honored. So you should be proud of this. How can you be proud if you don't show your love to your religion? Stick to the teaching of your religion. Some people, unfortunately, they say they are Muslim. They are proud of their Islam, which Allah Azza wa Jalla honor them. But at the same time, they find no problem to go and imitate those who were mistaken. This is why you see some Muslims, unfortunately, maybe you see them everywhere, in all media. They are waiting for the Christmas night to celebrate. Brother, you are a Muslim. He said, no, I'm not celebrating, I'm Muslim. But you see, this is a matter of social gathering, my neighbor, you know, be nice to my neighbor, my friends, my relatives who are not Muslim. I should show them that I'm nice and kind and I respect their religion. And then he shared in this practice, which we know is the practice of celebrating what they call it, the birth of the Son of God. So when you are congratulate somebody, you tell him Merry Christmas or any of these words. In fact, as you are saying congratulations for your bowing for an idol, for worshipping other than Allah, for being, subhanAllah, how come as a Muslim can claim that he is believing in Allah and his messenger? And then he go in a way which is very clear, shirk. Look at the Christmas. When did this start? Even Isa alayhi salam, he doesn't know this way. They claim that it is the birthday of Isa alayhi salam. But there's all the proof to them. As the historian, people have researched, this is one of the pagan festival, the Roman. So when the Roman Empire accepted Christianity or adopted Christianity to use it for its own purposes, what they did, they mixed and invented their festivals and their holidays, and they show it, they just put the cloth of Christianity over this new festival. So this is, you see, it's mixed of the pagan thought and practice and festivals with the misguided people who went astray and they lost the teaching of Isa alayhi salam. Is it easy, my dear brothers? Is it easy to say that Allah has a son or Isa alayhi salam is God? Look what the Quran said. وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَلَدًا لَقَدْ جِئْتُمْ شَيْئًا إِدَّا تَكَادُ السَّمَاوَاتُ يَتَفَطَّرْنَ مِنْهُ وَتَنْشَقُّ الْأَرْضُ وَتَخِرُّ الْجِبَالُ هَدًّا أَنْ دَعُوا لِلرَّحْمَنِ وَلَدًا. All the greatest creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they were shocked of insulting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this way. The meaning of this verse. And they say, the most merciful has taken for himself a son. You have done an atrocious thing. The heavens almost ruptured therefrom, and the earth split open, and the mountains collapse in the devastation that they attribute to the most merciful son. These great creations, they feel fear of Allah Azza wa Jal. that there is somebody who claimed that Allah has a son. And you see the Muslim who believe in the oneness of Allah, and he go and participate, and maybe congratulate, and maybe he give gifts or receive gifts. Where is the meaning of Tawheed? Where is the meaning of Tawheed? How dare a Muslim who believe in Allah and his Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he hear such this verses, he be happy to go and eat and celebrate with these people who believe that Isa alayhi salam is the son of God, or that he is God? Where is the honor of the Muslim who is really proud of his religion when he doesn't follow the teaching of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, violate the instruction and the teaching of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he knows the way of the truth, and then he follow his own desire, and he try to justify for himself in different ways? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقُ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعُ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمْ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. Remember this ayah, the meaning. Listen to the meaning. And whoever contradicts and opposes the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam after the right path has been shown clearly to him, and follows other than the believer's way, we shall keep him in the path he has chosen and burn him in the hell. What an evil destruction. La ilaha illallah. Following with that path, you will be with the same people of that path. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala advised us in the Quran, commanded us. This is command from Allah Azza wa Jalla. Allah said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تَتَّخِذُوا الْيَهُودَ وَالنَّصَارَى أَوْلِيَاءَ بَعْضُهُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ بَعْضٍ وَمَنْ يَتَوَلَّهُمْ مِنْكُمْ فَإِنَّهُ مِنْهُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. The meaning, all who have believed, do not take the Jew and Christian as allies. They are in fact allies of one another. And whoever is an ally to them among you, then indeed he is one of them. Allah guides not the wrongdoing people. What does it mean to be an ally? Different way. Either to love them, to follow their way, to imitate them, to share them in their festivals, or to wish their life, which is, you know, related to their religion. And Abi Sa'id al-Khudri رضي الله عنه قال, قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, لتتبعن سنن من كان قبلكم شبرا بشبر وذراعا ذراعا حتى لو دخلوا جحر ضب تبعتموه. قالوا يا رسول الله, اليهود والنصارى. قال فمن؟ رواه الإمام البخاري. The meaning of this hadith, Allah Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم said, you will indeed follow the ways of those before you, hand span by hand span, and an arm's length after another. Even if they enter into a lizard hole, you will follow them. We, the Sahaba, asked the Prophet, is it the Jew and the Christian? He replied, who else? Who else? And this is what many Muslims are doing. وفي مسند أحمد وأبي داود أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, من تشبه بقوم فهو منهم. The meaning, whoever resembles people is one of them. Is one of them. So my dear brothers, listen to this ayah. والذين لا يشهدون الزور وإذا مروا باللغو مروا كراما. And those who don't witness the to false to falsehood. And if they pass by some evil play or evil talk, they pass by it with dignity. So my dear brothers, sharing, participating, celebrating, greeting, anything of this, in fact, all this contradicts with the teaching of Allah and His Messenger. So this, what the ulama said, that Zur is, this is the non-Muslim festival, the pagan festival called Zur, because it's lying. It's lying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they ascribe, you know, a son to him, or they put idols beside him. تعالى الله عما يقولون علوا كبيرا بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم ما فيه من الآية وذكر الحكيم أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لعل الجليل لي ولكم ولسائر المؤمنين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله، الحمد لله وكفى، والصلاة والسلام على النبي المصطفى وعلى من سار على نهجه واقتفى. My dear brothers, what's our rule in this occasion? We know that our children, you know, or in most Muslim community, you know, now they know this. News separate, they use different ways. And you know, these people, there are some people who are using this occasion as a matter of business. This is why you see they spray it, not because it's religious for them, because it's commercial occasion, they can make money off. So this is why you'll find it everywhere, even in non-Christian countries. You'll see they are celebrating this occasion. What's our rule here? Now, my dear brothers, it is the right time that when you sit with your son, your children, your family, when they see all this going on and they say, what is this? What they are doing? What's a Christmas? It is time to teach our children the real aqeedah, the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To tell them what these people are doing, in fact, is a matter of shirk. Because they ascribe son to Allah. So it's a matter for education. It is also a time for da'wah. A time for da'wah. When you talk to a non-Muslim, a Christian, and you talk to him, and he tell you, why you don't celebrate Christmas? Explain to him why. Explain that this festival was not known by Isa alayhi salam. This festival, in fact, was inherited from the old pagan. And we as a Muslim, we believe in Isa alayhi salam as Messenger of Allah. We love him, respect him, but he is not more than a human being that Allah Azza wa Jal sent him same night as he sent many prophets ahead of him. قال تعالى وَلَن تَرْضَ عَنْكَ الْيَهُودُ وَلَا النَّصَارَى حَتَّى تَتَّبِعَ مِلَّتَهُمْ. Never will the Jew nor Christian be pleased with you till you follow their religion. No matter what you did, give them gifts, whatever you give, they will not be satisfied with you. Till you follow their way. So you choose either to follow the straight path, which we pray every day to keep, ask Allah Azza wa Jalla to keep us on, or to follow the other path. Inna Allah wa laikata wa sallamun ala al-Nabi, ya ayyuha al-lazina amanu, sallu alayhi wa sallim wa taslima. Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa ala Muhammad. كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم أنعم وبارك وصل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وعلى الخلفاء الأربعة الراشدين أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابة والتابعين ومن سار على نهجهم إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين، اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين، واحمي حوزه الدين، واجعل اللهم اهل البلد سخاء رخاء امنا مطمئنا وسائر بلاد المسلمين. اللهم احفظ بلادنا وبلاد الاسلام والمسلمين من شر الاسرار وكيد الفجار برحمتك يا عزيز يا غفار يا رب العالمين. اللهم اغفر المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات برحمتك يا مجيب الدعوات. اللهم آمنا في أوطاننا ودورنا وأصلح أئمتنا وولاة أمورنا واجعل اللهم ولايتنا فيمن خالق واتقاه واتبع رضاك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم وفق إمامنا بتوفيقك وأيده بتأييدك. اللهم ارزق كل بطانة الصالحة التي تدل على الخير وتعين عليه برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. فاذكروا الله العظيم الذي يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم، وذكر الله أكبر، والله يعلم ما تصنعون.